It's another beautiful Sunday afternoon with an exciting episode of King's Kitchen. Now, today we are spicing things up at Lake Victoria Serena, Kigo, where our special chef is bringing the heat with delicious achoki fish and posho ogali. If you ask me, please let's meet our chef, Chef Anthony
Pleasure.
Kenga.
Yes. My name is Anthony Kenga, as you've heard.
Habari?
Mzuri sana, habari yako.
Mambo?
Poa sana.
I think that's about it. That's as much as I can go. Okay, so thank you so much for having us here.
Pleasure hosting you.
Very well. Now, achoki sounds very not Ugandan.
Indeed, not Uganda.
So do tell, what's the story?
Basically, achoki is a... made of coconut tomato based sauce.
Okay.
Its origin is from the coast part of Kenya.
All right.
It was named after the first chef who invented, was called Silas Achoki. But over a very long time, we've decided to modify and bake it better with authentic cuisine, blending all spices and herbs and making more authentic.
All right.
And we reverse from Kenya and serving it in the Uganda way.
All right.
So when we serve it,
we serve on a plantain.
Oh,
plantain.
Yes. This is so Ugandan.
Yes.
It's so UG. Okay. So we know that it circles around fish, right?
Yes.
So we have our fish here.
Yeah. What we do is there are people who can't manage tilapia on bone.
Okay.
So instead, we give them option either to do fillet
of the same
grammage as the whole fried fish.
Okay.
Yes.
So depending on how you like it, if you want to go with a fillet, that's all on you.
Yes.
Or you want to do that, the fillet is good. You don't have to really worry about the bone.
Indeed.
Okay. So what do we have in here?
Here we have double breast chicken.
Okay. This one's story is for another day, right?
Indeed.
And this is served with?
These the achoki can be served with rice.
All right.
It can go well with ogali.
Uh-huh.
That has been the basic origin.
Matoke.
Ogali, but it goes
have
well.
Have a matoke.
Matoke.
Don't break my heart. Okay, all right.
But for the purpose of trial today, we can sample with matoke.
Well, we'll I love matoke, but I mean, hey, ogali is good as well. Posho is good. All right. What do we need?
So
I see there's all these ingredients.
These are all the ingredients.
Okay. This smells
this
like
ginger.
All right.
This is garlic.
Garlic.
This is onion.
Onion.
And its basic salad goes well with kachumbari.
Kachumbari.
Yeah, basically mixed tomato, onion.
This is for the garnish, pepper. Right?
This is garnish.
All right.
We call garnish.
All right.
Then the tomato makes the base with the coconut.
Okay.
Yeah. So when preparing, you
this
prepare
is the coconut,
it.
Guys.
Indeed. Indeed. And the coconut has a very beautiful story.
Yeah, do tell.
It is on the only fruit that the flesh is inside the seed. It's not like avocado, where the avocado is out, the seed is inside.
Oh, wow.
For coconut, it's the vice versa.
That's a brilliant story, Shay. Yeah. But we also have canned coconut.
Yes.
What's this? Coconut milk?
It is coconut milk.
But the coconut has its own milk on the inside, right?
Yes. But because we normally do with our mass production,
grating
this one and making it in the
like milky and right and smoothie. Okay.
So we blend with
this. I hear you.
Yeah.
All right. So you can't find these readily available in your supermarkets, but so can you find the coconuts in your markets. Okay. What's in here?
So this is the coconut milk.
This is how it looks like.
How we make it.
All right.
This is our base, where the salad sits on our garnishing on the plate.
Okay, and then we have a bit of lemon.
Yes, fish does well with lemon. So in
yes,
case anyone wants that sourness, there's lemon as garnish as well.
Okay, so let's kick it off. How do we start?
We need the cooking oil.
All right.
And ensure our pan is hot.
Okay, that's a very sizable pan.
Yeah. this panel basically has to be used to accommodate the whole fish.
Right.
Yeah. And again, it's not as deep as other pans because we will scoop it with its sauce. So when you have a pot like this, you may struggle to bring the fish up. So we need a flat pan like this.
I hear so you. Must the fish be pre-fried? Is that it?
Yes.
So you deep fried the fish before?
We deep fried. First, we marinate the fish.
Okay.
With our garden herbs. That involves garlic, ginger.
All right.
Some sage and coriander.
Okay.
So after marinade and a little bit of salt for seasoning and pepper, then we fat fry.
All right.
Yeah. We want to ensure it maintains the taste, either without the sauce or with the sauce. So that's the purpose we pre-cook.
Got it.
Yes.
Got it. Okay. So our pan
is ready.
All right.
Our first ingredient in this case
is send me. Onion. I'm lending hands. Okay, onion.
Onion is here.
This.
Yeah.
Far. How much of it?
Depending on the sauce. More, please.
More of it.
Yeah, that's enough. That's enough.
So the fire bit. I never get used to it. Okay, so what else? Whoa, I love it though. I love it.
While we start with the onion has a lot of water.
Okay.
So we need to dry that water by frying. So next ingredient is garlic.
Garlic.
We use the spoon.
Okay, how much garlic do we need?
About a full of that. Yeah, that is fine. That is okay.
I mean, we've seen people just get the garlic seed and just throw it in. Does it make any difference? Should we have to grate it or pound it? Does it matter?
The best way is to chop it.
Okay.
Yeah, it has to be cozy. The more you blend it fine, it tends to produce water again, which is not very good because...
Oh, all right.
It ends up... Put the ginger, please.
Ginger.
Yeah. Just little.
Just
half of
very
that.
Little.
Half of that, yeah.
More. Less is always more.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now ready, put all the tomatoes.
All right.
Yeah.
All of it.
All of it.
Oh. Do your thing, chef.
This one takes between 2 and 3 minutes.
When was the last time you did the pan flip and then it poured? When was the last time that happened to you?
The time I was still training.
How long ago
I
was that?
I wanted to learn so fast. that was the experience I
How had. Long ago was that?
About 20 years ago.
Oh. Chef!
Yes.
20 years!
I am that old.
I wasn't born yet. Oh, how long have you been cooking? What goes in next?
At this stage, you put the salt and seasoning.
20 years is a long time. How long have you been doing this?
I've been then that's the last 21
How much
years.
Salt?
Yeah, that's enough. Yeah.
21?
21 years.
Congratulations.
And I've been a chef for the last 13 years as an executive chef.
Oh.
Yeah.
What is it that has kept you in the kitchen? It's too much heat, too much smoke.
The love. The passion for it.
I love the sound of that.
Yeah.
What else?
So put little bit of the peppercorn.
All right.
Yeah. Pepper and salt are known for seasoning.
Okay, so that much?
That much is enough. Yeah.
Some grains are rather still solid. They're whole. Is there a reason why we prefer this to the powdered one? And
The powdered one are so grind as you put the same way you lifted this.
All right.
When you put this, it evaporates.
Is that so?
Yes.
Oh wow.
You would even have felt it if it were the powder. Everyone would start sneezing.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's because it's evaporating.
Yes.
It
so
makes
to avoid
sense.
That, now we ensure we grind it cozy.
Okay.
Yes.
That looks lovely. It looks like our sauce is perfect right now. And in there, you did mention that you get pretty much your things home, garden and pretty much to the kitchen. So this can be found in supermarkets or something, but you make your very own?
Yes.
You make your own coconut milk?
We make our own.
Oh, yes. Okay. This is nice. So this is Serena.
Yes.
Coconut milk.
Yeah.
I love that. I love that. Okay. Is that the point where we throw in our fish?
Yes. The first choice should be the fillet because it takes the shortest time to cook.
Okay.
Yeah. Again, when we are putting in the sauce,
yes,
we start on the right side. The right side is the filleted.
Oh.
This skin side is wrong side. So okay. When you put it, it tends to stick on the pan. So we start on the right side. So this is how we put it. And anytime you place it on a sauce, away from your face.
That, okay.
So
you
that
have to keep
this
the
does
face.
Not come to your face.
All right.
Yeah, you protect yourself.
I love the precaution.
Then now we put the second fillet.
All right.
Yeah. Now will you ensure it immerses.
Oh.
The whole of it is in the sauce.
Oh, yes.
Now you throw in on top of the fish. The process is called nappé.
It's called what?
Nappé.
Nappé?
Yes.
Ah.
Yeah. Nappé is the way you ladies normally do your makeup.
Ah.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So, you nappé the
right.
fish.
You nappé
yes.
the fish. You make up the fish pretty
exactly.
much.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah. So, when it simmers this, you tend to reduce the fire.
All right. You have to make sure the fire is not so much, right?
Yeah.
All right.
So,
okay.
You give it about 2-3 minutes, it's done.
Not very short time to wait,
very
right?
Short time.
Well, already, let's just go for a short breather. When we return, it's time for us to make our posho. Yeah. And then it. Are you looking for a home away from home? Just a place to get away from the hassle and bustle of the city. This here is just the perfect place. Just make your way to Lake Victoria, Serena, Kigo, a beautiful place. Delicious food, apparently, and this is the reason why we keep coming. Chef Anthony,
yes, please.
He is preparing achoki,
yeah,
achoki fish,
yeah.
And we saw the whole process, and now it looks like our fish is ready to
very
serve.
Ready for service. So, this is basically the flour.
All right,
our water here is boiling.
Okay,
we put our achoki aside so that it does not burn.
Right.
So when the water is boiling like this, we put the flour,
okay,
little and stir gradually as it makes.
Do you have any tricks as to how you make the posho? Because there's people that would rather go with measurements, portions of water, in relation to the posho, the amount of posho, anything, any need, or else they just come up with our porridge like posho.
It is your choice. Again, the people who love it posho when it is hard, some love it when it is soft.
When it's soft?
Yeah, so it is your choice. But basically, it has to start on a boiling water.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the best product.
You just need to put on. To keep on adding.
Yeah, yeah. Yes, because you can't measure the level of water versus the amount of flour you have.
Okay.
So you just need to put little gradually until you find the consistency you want.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Oh, good. Okay, already, Chef, let's plate this.
Yeah, it's ready for plating. You look at the plate.
Oh, yeah.
It resembles the fish.
It is like a fish.
Yeah. But we put this banana leaf as our underliner,
okay,
and make it authentically Ugandan.
Traditional.
Yeah, traditional.
All right.
Yeah. So this is where we normally put our fish fillets.
You know how we call this? We call it, do you know how we call it? Here in Uganda? Olulagala.
Ah.
Olulagala. How do you call it?
We call it banana leaves.
Okay. You can borrow our one.
I will.
We're generous.
I will.
You can use it. Okay. Yeah,
that I know.
All right.
The other plate is oval.
All right.
And this basically is the plate we use to serve our whole fish.
Yes.
And the achoki is because of the sauce.
Okay.
Other than that, when it is just fried, it's called fried fish.
Fried fish.
Yeah. So basically, again, this one is because we want to keep it Ugandan. We have this as our underliner.
Okay.
Yes. So now we are going to serve. We are starting with the fillet. Mm-hmm. We are serving the tilapia fillet.
Juicy.
Yeah, this is the fillet. Then we put the plate.
Okay.
Some sauce.
Are we right to say, Chef Anthony, that what makes achoki is everything to do with the coconut milk?
Yes, the coconut milk.
Alright.
Yeah.
If I put my beignet, it would be a different story.
Yes.
Okay.
So before we put the accompaniment, we have our salad.
All right. What do you need?
Yeah.
It is here. What do you need? All right. So are some of the things that you use for your bedding?
We use the lettuce.
It can only be lettuce?
It is only lettuce.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
That's the nice bed.
All right.
Yeah. Then our kachumbari.
All right.
Just mix salad.
Mix it up. I'll help with this.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
We put must lettuce. We care what it looks like when
very
it
important.
From?
Very important. We don't just throw.
Okay.
Yeah. We have respect for our food.
Right.
Yes.
It tastes nicer when it looks nice,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then
normally we need to have something to garnish.
Okay.
We are choosing this case. We have the spring onion. Yes.
Then we have a bit of coriander.
We can choose coriander, spring onion. But in this case, because our salad here has coriander. We don't want to repeat ourselves.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. On to the next.
Now, this what is lacking now is just the posho. Yes.
All right. Okay.
Now, we'll plate this with the whole fish.
That's a big guy.
Yes. This is how we lift it on the plate.
Ooh.
The sauce. Put enough sauce.
That's so good. Is it just me that's hungry?
Yeah.
I can't wait.
This is how it looks.
So good, right? Now I am hungry, Chief. Let's just go take a good sit at a perfect fine dining table and enjoy this meal. I love the juice, I love the place, and I love the food. But this here is my very first time to try out achoki chicken. So today we decided to just come and enjoy some kind of serenity. And Serena Hotel Kigo lives after its name. It's the ambience, it's just the food, it's the place itself, it's the people, the hospitality is everything. Everyone here is warm, and so is the food that we're about to test. But the man of the hour that has put this together is Chef Anthony, who is joining me for an awesome fine dine.
Indeed, indeed.
What a place. What a beautiful place you have here.
Yeah, with this signature dish,
right.
Achoki fish,
right.
We don't do it wrong.
Uh-huh.
We are not for this Kampala and beyond.
That's right. That's why we came all the way here to test this. All right. So ready to test our food. This blessed Father, we thank you for this food. Bless the hands that have prepared it and bless the viewers even as we enjoy it. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Okay, what I have here is fish, and it's a whole fish.
It's a whole fish.
This one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just to be keen, because it has bones.
Yes.
Yeah, but the taste
and
will make
you
forget.
And what you have there is fillet, so that is a little bit, and then a bit of, okay. There we have it. Mmm, this is good. This is so good.
This has just different touch.
Right.
We prepare with a lot of love and passion.
Absolutely.
Yeah, we go our way to ensure it's amazing and it's beyond the guest expectation.
I agree. This is so good. It just gave me another idea for what to do with coconut beyond just drinking it.
Yeah.
I love the flavor. This is very different. It's very unique. And I would love to try this out at home. But you as well at home, in case you want to come through. Come through to Serena Hotel Chigo and you will enjoy this deliciousness. Well, thank you so much, Shane. This is awesome, awesome, awesome. And that's a wrap for today's episode of NBS King's Kitchen. Now, if you desire further gastronomic journeys, you can get yourself the Afro mobile app for more recipes, inspiration. Until next time, keep the passion alive in your kitchen. And for me and Chef Anthony, happy cooking.